Hi everyone, I'm going to be painting this portrait for you today. I'm really happy to be doing this. I'm going to go at my own pace. I'm not going to talk a whole lot. Just make a few comments here and there. If you want to learn to do this, head over to my website and check out my sales page for my Procreate Portrait Painting Zoom workshop. All right, I'm just going to get started here. Start. A little color down. A lot of like soft, kind of greenish reflected light on him, his face. A little greener. I like to exaggerate the color a little bit. see. What else? What else? I'm just putting down an initial layer of tone. You always got to start somewhere, so. And a little bit bigger. Those glasses kind of get those in there a little bit. Those glasses are hugging the side of his nose here. It's starting to get somewhere. About his shirt, just to get something down. Fun. That a little browner. I want him to be prematurely gray. He's a young man. It's too much. Some of the brushes respond to pressure and some not as much. This one that I'm using does. This comes down a little bit more. Closer. right, great. Good start. Now at this point, I sometimes I'll smudge this layer. Let's see whether I want to do that here. A few of these folds. It's like a little bit of a cast shadow here. From his face and across. Super nice. Up here. Sort of a got some gray to it. Here. And that's a little much. Take those out. Head to more like that. Oop. Crosses. It's got a cast shadow from his glasses. It's going across his face a bit. Too much color, so blend that together a little bit there as well. It's got a nice strip of color down the center of his nose. That's too much. And that doesn't feel like the right color. Let's see. Like that. That's more like it. It's a bit too red, but I'm going to leave it there for now. I'll come back to it. All right. to get some color in his eyes. Kind of gray. Darker. Great. Okay, I think it's just about time for another layer. Like sometimes, that a little bit. Just kind of checking out what that's going to be like. And brown. It's got some good eyebrows on him. All right, so now I've got some color down, got some good stuff happening. So now time to get a little more serious about getting the extremes of my value range in here. strong values in there. It really starts to pop. Fun. Little artifacts from the strokes. I don't mind. Some of that I think is definitely adds to the texture, and towards the end I'll be really building some texture and mark making. Let's see, I want something a little darker over here. Right in there under his nose, and then does the plane of his nose, that's important. Nose is one of the places that I tend to go awry, so I won't pay attention to what I'm doing. Made him smile just a little bit more than he is. He's looking a little grumpy in the photo, so a little bit happier attitude. Overdo it. Color in there. It's a little darker. That's nice. Pencils. Yeah, he's looking good. I like to spend some time with the little details of clothing and glasses and jewelry and that kind of thing. Just kind of makes it, gives gives it a nice polish. Switch brushes again. Now I'm going to start to play with these edges a bit more. A little bit of texture. Go a little darker. Use that background to cut back in. Pencil. Maybe that light right there. Maybe a little much. Whoop. Didn't want to do that. Puna. Much, maybe not that light. Turned out pretty cool. Now, last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come and I'm going to restate some of my line work. Something I like to do, it just gives it a certain sort of vibe of this looseness and sketchiness. Gives me a chance to get some of these drawing things going that I might have ignored while I was in that sort of painting phase. I see something I want to work on right here. Sort of a transition. Yeah, that's really nice. It's darkening a couple spots here. Fun. actually think this needs to go a little bit darker right there. And this earlobe comes down. Almost missed that. Good. I just am wanting to rough this up a little bit here and there. I'm glad he's smiling just a tad more. No lower lashes, just a bit. There's anything in his glasses. Oh, yeah. Just cleaning that up a little. It's quite a bit happier than that. This a little lighter right here. A little strong. I like that color right there, but it's probably not great placement. And let's see, I want to get that eye. The white of his eye is not that light right there. It's pretty dark, actually. Go in here. Wow, yeah. It's pretty dark. But it works. It's kind of surprising how dark it is. Okay, I'm just going to clean up a couple little things here and there. So this is so much fun. It's really, really addictive. Pretty much do these every single day now. Just love it. It's kind of no mess, no fuss kind of way to do a drawing, painting practice. see, I want to get the top of that hat. Light. That. I think that's good. And then some, probably some line right here is in order. Right. Yeah, so if you want to learn how to do this, join me in my Procreate workshop. And I'll show you all the little tips and tricks and ins and outs of Procreate and its interface. It's really fun once you get used to it. It's pretty easy. Yeah, see, I can hardly stop. Just want to keep going and going. Just loads of fun. And it's also something you can do with your grandkids or, you know, can do it sitting in front of the TV. You can, you know, you could take it anywhere with you. So to me, it's just the most perfect sketchbook practice. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the demo. All right, bye-bye.